and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight we're going to read Go Go Gorillas, a romping bedtime tale. It was written by Patrick Wensick and illustrated by Nate Ragg. It was published by HarperCollins Publishing Company. I'm going to dedicate it to my friend Brenly all the way up in Maine. On every safari, gorillas come last. Most kids never stop. They just speed on right past. They claim apes are dull. They say apes are boring. This one's yawning and this one is snoring. But they're not as lazy as everyone thinks. These apes have a reason they need 40 winks. Wait until dark. When you think they can't see, that's when our apes get footloose and free. What does it mean to get footloose? What are they going to do? It's the end of the day, so a giant meal's first. They chomp so much food that their bellies could burst. Bananas in bunches all vanish like ghosts. Mountains of marshmallows sit ready to toast. Then Jungle Jed comes and he speaks soft and low. All you apes, grab your jammies and go, go, go. Brush your teeth, comb your fur, read a story or two. In the morning, more people will be here for you. Telling them it's bedtime. Go get ready for bed. For a minute or more, it might look like they're sleeping, but soon they're unleashing the secret that they're keeping. Slowly and slyly, each slips from a bunk. Baby picks records of reggae and funk. Those are two different types of music. This trend catches on as their toes give a wiggle, their arms loosen up, and their hips start to jiggle. Now, this is a party, the night of all nights. Mirror balls, DJs, and bright flashing lights. Are they having a dance party? Yeah, that's what it looks like and sounds like to me. How fun. The dance floor goes crazy. The apes form a ring, all swirling and twirling and strutting to swing. Some tango, some Charleston. One does the foxtrot. But baby's old school. He does the robot. Do you know what the robot is, boys and girls? That's a fun dance move. Maybe ask mom and dad to show you the robot. The fun's really roaring, and then Jed's at the door. Apes fall from the ceiling and land on the floor. It's bedtime, he shouts. And here's my last warning. You all know the children will be here by morning. The apes hush themselves. Soon they're all zonked out cold. You can hear great big snores from the young and the old. Look at how cute the apes are all dreaming. Jed's proud of himself. He walks away beaming. Right there he's walking away happy, right? And he's saying, shh. He's probably tiptoeing away because he thinks they're all asleep. He finally got them to bed. Or did he? Do you think they're really sleeping? See a couple with their eyes open, or at least one eye open. What does that mean? Hey, wait a minute. From the waltz to the polka, apes know every dance. Each time the clock chimes, they all conga like ants. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, they weren't done with their dance party, were they? They want to keep on going. It's the time of their lives. Some swing from the treetops, and then Jed storms back in, and the whole room just stops. Right? They all freeze because they were caught again. They hold in their breath while Jed shakes his big fist. That shake spreads through his body. Let's all do the twist! Wait a second. Now Jed's going to join in. He wants to do the twist. Jed chooses a partner. He calls out a tune. No wonder they love dancing under the moon. Jed wows the whole crowd with his feet oh so light, and they groove and they boogie away the whole night. The secret dance ends as the sunlight starts dawning. The apes move so slowly. They're stretching and yawning. This trouble is double for one jungle guide. Jed grabs a big blanket and crawls under to hide. See, you can't blame gorillas for snoozing all day. They just don't have pep left from smiling and play. Think twice if you're tempted to pass them on by. Tonight, they just might need a dance partner your size. Oh, what if they call you into dance, my friends? Wouldn't that be something? I think it would be a lot of fun. I would love to dance with the apes. All right, let's stop our dancing and settle on down for the night. It's time to get cozy, get calm, and sing our lullabies so we can get ready for bed. We're going to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, followed by God Bless the Moon. And I hope you'll sing with me at home. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. And now, our moon lullaby. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless you, my friends at home. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.